Becky. If you read the title and saw the thumbnail of this video, you may think it's clickbait, but I promise you, it really isn't. This is actually a real thing that could be happening to my channel and also to so many other YouTubers that you no doubt watch and love. They could very, very realistically be going away. And YouTube itself could be changing completely and may be something that might not even exist much longer if things don't change. So you may have heard me or anybody else on YouTube talking about something called COPPA, which is the Children's Online Protection Privacy Act. COPPA is basically a set of laws that was made in 1998, which is designed to help protect children under the age of 13 when it comes to their privacy. Now, obviously in 1998, there was not anywhere near what there is now as far as YouTube and things like that. That didn't exist back then. So there was no, the rules that were made back then were not designed to protect kids against the technology that we have now. So they are very outdated. Basically, YouTube was in trouble with the FTC because I guess children were watching that were under the age of 13, and it was, they were either lying and saying they were not under the age of 13, or they were using their parents' YouTube account, and therefore that was in violation of COPPA, saying that that was the breaking the privacy laws for children under 13 as far as the ads that are on YouTube and the demographic information that is collected when you watch a YouTube video and when you watch the ads. There is information collected by YouTube's intelligence to figure out what ads to show you in the future and what videos to suggest to you in the future. That is how YouTube works. That's how the ads work, and that's how YouTube really can find trends in what you watch to suggest other videos that you may be interested in. And there may be people that you have found on YouTube that you love and watch every day now that were suggested to you by YouTube. And that's how YouTube gets that information, by that artificial intelligence and those different algorithms that reads the information that you are watching this type of content or you're clicking on these certain ads. This is what you're interested in. So they know what to show you again over and over in the future. Well, the problem is children now, so many children that are on YouTube, 13 and under, are still protected under COPPA laws. And so that is supposed to be a violation of those protection and privacy laws for children. Because if it was a child watching their adult's account, their mom and dad's account, or if it's a child who has their own account and lied and said they were over the age of 13, that's against the law. So basically the FTC fined YouTube somewhere around $170 million because they were in violation of those COPPA privacy laws. So flash forward, it has now had a trickle down effect because basically the FTC laws for COPPA are very, very strict. They're very vague and they're very outdated. So they are basically trying to force creators into making content that is 100% following the law. But like I said, the law is very vague, like not to have direct content that is directed to children. Or if it is directed to children, then you have to designate that your videos or your channel are designated for children. Therefore, you will most likely not receive any revenue whatsoever for anybody that happens to watch that video. You will also not be allowed to have comments. It will also not be suggested by YouTube to anyone if you have a video and or channel that is designated for children. That's basically shutting you down, because if you know how YouTube works, yeah, YouTubers get money sometimes from companies to do sponsored videos, but most of the time, the most consistent income comes from people watching the ads that are played in front of your videos. So if your videos do not have ads, therefore you make little to no money whatsoever from AdSense, which is basically the service that pays you when people watch those ads. I'm trying not to be confusing about it. It is kind of confusing. And you may think this doesn't matter to you, because you may think, well, I don't live in the United States. Or you may think, well, I don't watch a video or videos or channels that are designated for kids. The problem is, the way the laws are written right now, if they say that your videos are directed towards children, it doesn't matter whether they are or not. My gift guide videos, if they say that they are for children, even though they are definitely not for children, they are for the parents of children to get gift ideas, If they say though they're for children and I say they're not, I can be fined $42,000 per video that I say is not for children, but that they say is for children. And the problem is, because the laws are so vague, there's no like black and white of clarity between this is for kids, this isn't. They are downright like to the specifics of if your channel or videos have bright colors, if they have music, if they have toys, certain foods, snacks, cereal, certain words, certain animations, certain cartoons, certain graphics. They can designate those videos or channels as for children, even if they aren't. That's the problem. That's the danger zone, because the laws are vague and they're not helpful for us as creators. Because yeah, my channel banner is aqua and has little cartoon birds on it, but that doesn't mean it's for children. I happen to like little tiny birds that look like cartoons. That's for me. I happen to like aqua and teal, and so I pick that as my color for my banner. That does not mean it's for children, but the laws, the way they are written right now, I could very easily be deemed as designated for children, even though not one single video I make is about children or for children. If children watch it, I can't help that, but that's not deliberately or intentionally made for children. And this is just me, and I'm talking about Disney and homeschooling and gift ideas. Think about all the other channels that you watch that have children in them. Family vlog channels, toy unboxings, anything that the FTC says looks like it could be for children, they have the right to fine those people $42,000 per video and take off any monetization on those videos because they think they're for children. This is the problem. So no one at this point on YouTube is safe unless you are just making like, you know, extreme adult videos with lots of profanity or violence and all of that stuff. Unless you're doing those type of things, you're probably not safe. And that's the thing. And it's going to either go two ways. It's either going to force people like me and other people who make content that is, you know, in a trickle down way, maybe benefiting parents and their children, but it's not for children, or people that are showing their kids and their family vlogs or anything like that. It's gonna make people like me either completely have to stop making videos, or it's gonna push other people into making more adult type videos. So more profanity, different types of topics that are definitely not gonna be misconstrued as for children. It's gonna go either that way, or it's gonna shut people down. And that's really where I am, and I'm concerned. And I was thinking going forward, because all of this is supposed to take place January 1st. Like, these laws are supposed to be cracked down on January 1st. And I thought, okay, going forward, I'll worry about that in January. Come to find out, it's also retroactive. Any videos you've already made previous to January 1st, those are also susceptible to that $42,000 per video fine and to losing any monetization. So that means all of the work that I've done leading up to this point could also be at risk. And anybody else that makes videos, anything they've done previous to January 1st could also be at risk. And basically, this all boils down to a set of laws that were made so long ago that didn't even have YouTube on their radar and didn't understand the way that culture is now with streaming services and social media and YouTube. Those laws don't apply to the way things are done now. And if they are going to make them apply, and I'm all about protecting children, you guys know I am, you have to lay the responsibility for this at the parents. The parents of these children should be the ones to monitor what they're watching and how they're watching it. And if they don't want them on the main YouTube channel, there is always YouTube Kids, which is a much safer environment for kids. There's always that option. But because of this, and because these children are watching YouTube, whether they're supposed to be or not, with parental permission, it's affecting us as creators because it could very well cost us our channels. And for me, this has been a long time trying to make my channel what it is. I love my YouTube channel. It started out as a hobby and I did not make a single dime from my channel for 3 years. I think that proves that I love it. I loved it when I was doing it for free, and I love it now because I am actually making money on it. I make money through AdSense and I make money through sponsored videos, and you guys know that. I don't think you guys care that I'm making money on this because I did it when I wasn't making money, and I'm still doing it because I want to share with you guys. But yes, being able to make money on YouTube has been a huge blessing for my family. It has paid for several trips to Disney World. It helps pay the bills every single month. and I love my channel. If I had to stop getting money for my videos, I could not make them anymore. Yes, I made them for 3 years for free, but my life was a lot different then. Some of that time, I only had one child that was homeschooling, and I didn't spend nearly as much time on it then as I do now. There's no way that I could spend the amount of time on my channel going forward if I didn't make any money on it, because it takes too much time away from things I need to be doing with my family and my house. There's so many times my house is a wreck. Like right now, I need to be cleaning, but I'm not, because I want to make videos for you guys and I want to share with you guys and talk to you guys. But I can't do that for free anymore, and nobody else really wants to either. People that you watch on YouTube, you may take for granted the fact that they're there for you guys, but there is so much time invested in planning videos, filming them, editing them, working with companies, going back and forth, making changes, making thumbnails, doing tags and description box and links and all these things that we have to do, which we love doing it, but it takes a lot of time, and it's not too much to ask or to expect to not do it for free. And that's basically what's gonna happen if the laws go in effect the way they are written right now. So there are things that you guys can do to help save my channel and every other channel that you watch on YouTube. There is something that you can do. And basically that's why I'm making this video, to try to share it with you guys, to get the word out there. This is going on, even if you don't understand the ins and outs of it. If you want to read the COPPA laws, you can. There's actually a link for them below. You can get on there and look and see the laws and how they are supposed to be so specific, but they're also extremely vague and not helpful at all to people like me who want to know, like, what is the FTC is gonna, what are they gonna say is for children? Is it something as simple as the fact that I have Aqua on my channel banner, or a little cartoon bird, or that I use music in my videos? Like, what is gonna be this potential hazard that sets the FTC off to make them possibly say that my videos are for children and therefore take off monetization and or fine me $42,000 per video? That's the scary part. That is really, really scary for me as a creator and as a mom and as somebody who does not have $42,000 to pay anybody. Just laying around. I mean, what would I do? What are you gonna do? You can't squeeze blood from a turnip. I don't have $42,000 in my savings account. I would have to sell my house in order to be able to pay just one video violation of $42,000. Not much less if they decide to say more than one of my videos was in violation. That's scary. And it's putting a lot of us in a very uncertain place about the future of our channel. So you guys can do something for me and for every other YouTuber that you watch and you let into your home. There's actually a petition that you can sign. Anybody can sign it, whether you are a content creator or you are just a viewer of YouTube. Anybody can sign this petition to say, hey, you need to revisit these laws before you put anything else into place. You need to revisit these laws and change them for today's technology and the way that we watch TV and the way that we watch YouTube and the way that we get our entertainment. They need to reevaluate the laws. There's also a spot where you can write comments to the FTC about what you think about the COPPA laws. And like I said, I am all about protecting kids. I'm one of the most conservative people I know when it comes to what I let my kids watch. That being said, the FTC and anything else should not replace parental observation and guidance. It is the parents' job of these children to find out what they are watching on YouTube and how they are watching it. And it should not be at the creator's expense to lose their livelihood just because the parents are choosing either to not let their kids use YouTube Kids, which is a much safer environment, or they're letting them online and without knowing what they're doing. We can't be around all the time. I get that. I know that. You cannot sit there and stare over your child's shoulder all the time. But most of the kids that are watching YouTube on the main YouTube channel, it's their parents' account. And their parents know. Or their parents will hand them their phone and say, here, watch this video. But that's not allowed in the eyes of the FTC. Because they say, no, if you're under 13 years old, you are not allowed to have a YouTube account. And you shouldn't be watching it, because if you are, we're gonna take money and monetization and ads off of these videos so that you cannot see these ads. That's basically what it boils down to. And so those links for you guys in the description box, there is one to sign the petition to the FTC. You can click on that link and read more about it, but basically you are saying to the FTC that you do not agree with the COPPA laws the way they are written, And there's also a section where you can write a comment in to the FTC, whether you're a YouTube creator or you're a viewer and you just want to voice your opinion about what you think about the laws and what you think about what they're doing on YouTube and how it is affecting content creators. You can say whatever you want as long as you're please being respectful. But I mean, this is basically the government telling you what you and your children can and cannot see. We have until December 9th is the last day where they will be accepting comments. From what I've heard, they actually welcome comments. They are wanting people to write in and give their opinions. So definitely leave your comment. Even if you don't sign the petition, at least comment to the FTC and let them know what you think about this. How do you feel about the fact that their laws are outdated and are not relevant to today's technology, and they are not specific enough for people who are making videos on YouTube? So I really encourage you to read the COPPA laws and see what they say. Write the FTC and give them your opinion of what you think about this. And if you want to, also sign that petition, because the more people that we have behind this expressing our concern over all this, the better. It may not make a difference whatsoever, but it may make a difference. But if it doesn't change things and things are let to go on the way they are now, it could very well be the end of my channel and possibly every other channel that you watch. So if you don't want that to happen, I highly recommend that you click on the links in the description box, read the information on COPPA. I will link a video for you guys if you want to watch that, where they say much better than I did in this video kind of what's going on and how it can affect people and how it's going to affect you and how it's going to affect YouTube and the YouTubers that are making videos for you guys. That video much more concisely will tell you what's going on and what you can do about it. But please, if you like my channel and you watch YouTube and you have other YouTubers that you watch and you love and you don't want to see them go away, definitely check out those links, sign the petition, leave the comment for the FTC, because hopefully it can make a difference, because I would really, really hate to stop making videos for you guys. I love making them for you, but I love my channel for me. It has been such an amazing outlet for me. It has provided for us so much financially, and it has given me so much fulfillment and creativity, and I love it so, so much, and I would really, really hate to not be able to make videos for you guys anymore. So please check out the links in the description box. All that information is there for you guys. I really appreciate your support. And I don't know what else to say. So hopefully we can make a difference. Like I said, we have until December 9th, because I believe December 10th, the FTC is making any final decisions, changes to the COPPA law. So it is important that you really get your comment in and you sign that petition before December 9th. So please do that if you're going to, as soon as possible. And I really, really appreciate your guys' support. And I know every other YouTuber out there appreciates your support as well. And feel free to share this video with anybody that you know that enjoys YouTube, which is pretty much everybody in the world. Anybody that you know that watches YouTube that may not know about this or may not know how they may be able to help, definitely feel free to share my video or the video in the description box. Like I said, it's much better than mine. That'll explain it, kind of what's going on and what we can try to do about it. So thank you so much for watching. I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.